out there. that goes 13 feet into the ground and 55 feet up into the air and 45 feet across. It has taken 80 mile per hour winds when it was just a blur. So these are very special. These are a right from Gallus right now. And later we're going to give you, after we've lit you up, we're going to let you bid on them. They will be taken from your tables and we will bring out cakes because you're going to be so inspired by tonight's honoree. And those whirligigs will go over there and you can bid on them, hopefully copiously. So I want to thank everybody, particularly the best staff in the world that pulls everything together, and the board of directors that we had who cornered all their friends to come here tonight. And I thank them. So many of you may have brought multiple tables, and I will thank each one of you. I'm so frightened of saying names up here because I am afraid I'll forget somebody. Now, we made a boo-boo because spelling was never one of my strengths, nor too many of my staff, with our sponsor, Jay Vinton Schaefer, who is also our builder. Now, can that table scream out, how do I have to spell Schaefer?
Give me an S.
An S.
Give me a C.
C.
Give me an A.
N.
Give me an A.
N.
Give me an F.
F.
Give me an E.
E.
Give me an R.
R.
What's that spell?
Schaefer. Budget. Our architect is also here, Diane Cho. She's the other person putting the hole in her down with the pool. All right. Now, let's review shortly our 11 years of gala. I'll just give you the highlights. We've had actors John Glover. We had the gorgeous Salma Hayek. We had the handsome Edward Norton Jr., for whom is the grandson of this Jim Rouse Visionary Center. We have had Rosie O'Donnell, the foremost promoter and investor in foster care in this country. And we've had two Nobel Prize winners, the scientist Dr. Peter Ogden, and we had our Holy Age Duo show here. And we've also had the Nobel Prize winning peacemaker, Reverend Archbishop Desmond Tutu. And he and Rosie were the best pair you could imagine. That was just last year. You heard of Rosie and Desmond Tutu from your last year. Thank you for being so good. Now, so from that background, how are we going to choose our honoree this year? Well, this is how much we respect cake dough and icing and visionary championing of those things beyond any visionary dreams any foodie ever had. So we brought our very good friend, who is a good friend to all his friends, and he owes, I know, a little bit of a debt to our own Alicia, because I understand when Duff Goldman came here to do his very first bride, bridal shower, he didn't even have business cards. And Alicia says, honey, you go right over to Kinko's and get those cards. And the rest is history. How many of you have seen those big billboards on Times Square with a picture on them? Asa kids, I haven't seen you tonight, but I have to tell you, you are real. There you are, right back. I'm looking like, I met your Western wear. That's your Western wear. I thank you with all my heart for being our honoree. You have groupies everywhere. You're my favorite visionary chef, cook, icing, divine, supreme mogul that I've ever known. So I thank you so much. But tonight, let's get our food on, okay? And no, we have been given the opportunity to put on the West Coast of America, in the city of Los Angeles, a West Coast branch of this National Museum. We have to raise our endowment first, but we are debt-free and we're well on to our way of being devoted to that task with our hands. The vision is from Sea to Shining Sea. So I want to thank everybody who's here tonight. Put us in your will, please, okay? Talk to every rich person you ever met, because we'll sell the naming rights for $25 million, pay up over 5 years. They can be the Bill and Betty Smith American Visionary Art Museum, okay? Your name here. So thank you, have a best time tonight, and we'll get the food from Charles Levine started now. Thank you all. and the buffets are open, so go get it. But no, like, stampede. No stampede, you know, orderly going to the buffets. Are they all the same serving the table? It's all buffet? Okay, it's buffet, but it's really good. Thank God for Charles Camino.
Hey guys! Alright, so... has everybody seen the show? Has anyone not seen the show? Does everybody know what I do for a living? Does anybody not know what I do for a living? Raise your hand! I didn't do it! Alright. So, here's the deal. I make cakes, right? Big, crazy, wild cakes that shoot fire and do all kinds of stuff. And I put motors in them and lights and, have fun with them. A long time ago, before any of us were born, my great-grandmother came over from the Ukraine to this country. And she came over, she was 14. She came over and eventually moved to Wichita, Kansas, to start the Jewish Mafia there, which is kind of bizarre. My great-grandmother settled in Wichita, and she was a milliner. She made ladies' hats. And she was also a weaver, and she was a baker. And I remember as a kid, I only knew her for a very short time, but I remember as a kid, she would make a ball of dough, and then she would start at the corner of her dining room table, right? And she'd just start kind of flapping away at it, just kind of hook it over one of the corners, and she'd be flapping away at it.
Oh, sorry, sir.
She was good friends with that guy. When I was a kid, when really young, punk ass, she used to take me down to Santa Fe before there was a Starbucks. You know what I'm saying? Like, she was that kind of grandma. She was really, really, really cool. My grandma had a daughter, my mom, and my mom is well, big, take, you name it, Arkwell, everything. And the thing that was so cool is that, like, it had that same sense of danger about it. You know what I mean? Like, it was like, you could get seriously maimed in a schmelting accident. You know what I mean? You know, like seriously, like, you could get hurt in trains and building metal, parking, you name it. And so I started cooking. And I would use all that money to buy the material to make the stuff that I did. And then one day I realized, wait a minute, the only really marketable skill that I have is cooking. And I like it. It's fun. So I started cooking more and more and more, and kind of like, I still made art, you know, I still did a lot of drawing, painting, and, you know, traditional. I ended up beating up Towson's coach and I got kicked off. Oh no, I didn't get kicked off. I got a 5-game suspension, but then we got banned from playing Towson until I graduated. Went to UMBC, graduated with a degree in philosophy. You know? I was working for Cindy Wolf at the time, helping pay for school. It turned into a culinary school. It was CIA at Greystone. Beautiful place. I felt like Harry Potter when I walked in there. When you walk in, it's like, whoa. Amazing, right? So I go in there the day, and that I was a bread baker. And then towards the end of school, we started doing like the really, really like kind of skillful stuff. And one of those things was cakes. So we baked a bunch of cakes. Ooh, Mr. Frank Warner. So, you know, I was just like the bread baker, you know, like guy would carry around a 100-pound sack of flour and, you know, big breath. And, you know, I'd come to school, you know, my windows down, blasting death metal. I'm making these cakes, and all my classmates are like, you? Like, come on, are you kidding me? Like, why are you good at that? So then my teachers were like, hey, you should really do this for a living. And I was like, decorate cakes? And I was like, you know, I was like 23, you know, 22, I don't know, I was young. And so I was like, maybe later, you know, I don't know. Then I went back to the hotel, and I looked at the purchase orders for all the wedding cakes. They got like 5-6 grand for a cake. And I was like, you know what, maybe I should start doing this. This is ridiculous. Like, these guys make my salary in like a week, you know? So, and then one day I got a phone call, and
you didn't know that, did you?
So I did that. And so that's literally how I started, was coming here, making cakes, you know, and bada bang, you know, one day to help them. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a cake and we're gonna put it on everybody's table, and then you guys are gonna decorate it, and then I'm gonna judge it. But don't worry, because like I don't really care about rules or anything like that. You can lick your fingers, you can lick your fingers, you can do stuff. It's alright. Alright, and there's categories, hold on. That's basically for the worst cake in the house. The second place is what we found award. And then the first place is the creme de la creme. Perfection de la confection. You are the icing on the cake and the topper of the butter of the cake ready. 2000.
Then take charge. Correct all activity.
I mean, you're just still left.
Where's it a bar?
Now I'm sir.
Christine, are you with the idea of raising the house up another?
Thank you. my soul on the top. This life I'm bound to lead ain't for the faint of heart. And you will fall over me if no one's good for you. So I won't lie. Oh, I can love you like the devil. He wanted me to tonight. And we can talk about forever, for a day or two. Come on, people! I still got a lot of leaving left to do. You can turn.